Historical personality, but he is the supreme personality of God. According to Vedic literature, we get information that God comes within all kinds of society, not only human society, but in animal society also. And why does he come? When does he come? These descriptions and informations are there in the Vedic literature, very nicely. So one has to study. Sometimes people object that God cannot come as incarnation. But we don't agree to that point. If we say that God cannot come, that means God becomes subjected to our order. He is so great and independent, then why he shall not come? If he likes, he can come. We don't agree to the philosophy that God cannot come. Why God cannot come? If he is actually the great, whatever he likes he can do. That is God's solution.
What is Krishna consciousness then?
Yes, that is very important. Krishna consciousness is described very nicely in the Bhagavad Gita. Perhaps you know Bhagavad Gita. I understand you are reading Bhagavad Gita. So, Bhagavad Gita is the guide how to become Krishna conscious. There is a statement by Krishna himself in the 9th chapter. Manmana bhagavan bhakta madhyaji maam namaskri. Manmana, just always think of me, become my devotee, always think of me. Manmana bhagavan bhakta madhyaji, worship me, offer obeisances unto me. These are the different processes how one can become Krishna conscious.
How does Krishna consciousness differ from other yoga systems?
Yoga system is also Krishna consciousness. But the modern yoga system is a different manufacturer of the latest atheist class. They meditate upon something impersonal, void. That is very difficult. You cannot concentrate your mind on something void. That is simply troublesome. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Klesha adhikatara stresham abhakta tattva chetattva. Those who are attached to the impersonal, void feature of the Absolute Truth, their process is very troublesome. So, Krishna has got defined features of his manifestation. The first feature is impersonal. The second feature is localized. And the third feature is localized by the Supreme. So, generally, the yogis, they try to concentrate on the impersonal. Actually, they should have concentrated on the localized feature. The localized feature is called Paramatma, and the impersonal feature is called Brahma. And the personal Vita is called Bhagavan. That is explained very nicely in Srimad Bhagavatam. The absolute truth is one. Impersonal, personal and localized, the thing is one. But according to a different vision, in the beginning it is impersonal, farther advanced it is localized, and farther advanced it is personal. So, yoga system of the modern day, first of all I may say, most of them are not very bona fide. They are simply humbug. Actual yoga system, Ashtanga yoga, eight different stages of practicing yoga is not possible at the present day.
What is the relationship between Christ and Krishna?
That is very simple to understand. Christ represented himself as Son of God. So we are not different. That's the thing, the Son of God.
In the Bible, the Lord Christ said that the only way to worship God is through me.
Yes, that's fine. Because unless you get association of a devotee, there is no question of God really. So, Jesus Christ is a devotee, so one has to associate with the devotee before realizing the devotee. But it is not that God has got only one devotee. If God is unlimited, He has unlimited devotee also. That is real philosophy. But the philosophy which was spoken by Lord Jesus Christ, that society was different from the society where Krishna appeared, or Krishna spoke, just like Krishna spoke to Arjuna. And Jesus Christ spoke to some visionary. The shepherds, which is the status of life and their understanding given. The representative of God speaks according to the circumstances, according to the country. So it was good for the people at that time. They should have concentrated through this stuff.
Is Krishna consciousness sectarian? Can anyone take it up? Can Christians take it up? Can Muslims take it up?
Yes, you can see practically. All our students here in Western countries, they're mostly coming from Christian group, Greek group. And there are many Mohammedans also. And this Negro, all kinds of, everyone is welcome. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Although materially there is gradation of first class, second class, third class, human society, but Krishna is saying that anyone, manhi pārtam the pārsit, anyone who takes proper shelter of me, this is very important thing. Proper shelter means to take shelter of Krishna. But in the physically, absence of Krishna, one has to take shelter of Krishna's real representative. Then anyone will understand this Krishna philosophy and will be elevated to the highest platform or understanding.
With what authority do you teach this Krishna consciousness?
Well, I told you, Bhagavad Gita is authority. Just like when you go to the law court, you speak on the law.